Before you can start stitching, you have to have thread in the top and the bottom of your sewing machine. And of course, the thread in the bottom is on a bobbin. And you have to wind your bobbin before you can put it in your machine to use. Sounds like a lot of steps, doesn't it? If you have a bobbin that has a hole in it and you need to put the thread through the hole first before you can wind that bobbin, you're going to want to watch this video to find out a really easy way to do that. Hi, I'm Kim Jamieson-Hirst. I'm an online educator and the host of The Quilter's Way, the only online quilting membership that combines learning and socializing. Before we get into today's video, be sure to subscribe and hit the bell so you'll be notified the next time I have a new video. Now, I have issues with my vision that makes it very difficult for me to thread my thread through that little hole in the bobbin before I'm able to wind my bobbin. And I'm using a Janome MC9450, and that's how you have to get your thread into the bobbin before you wind it. That's the best way to do it anyway. Whatever machine you're working with, make sure you check your manual to learn how to wind your bobbin and make sure that you use the bobbins made for your machine, because even though bobbins may look the same, trust me, there can be a very slight difference and it can make the world of difference when you go to use it in your sewing machine. You don't want to wreck your sewing machine, so check your sewing machine manual to make sure you have the right kind of bobbins to use in it. And I have a question for you. Do you have your sewing machine manual close by? Do you even know where it is? Bonus points if you have it near your sewing machine. So let me know in the comments below if you actually know where your sewing machine manual is and where it is. Okay, let's get back to this threading the bobbin thing. What I like to use to do this is what's called easy threading needles. Now these needles have like a little H sort of in the top. So you don't actually have to get your thread through the hole in the needle. You just need to pull it down into the needle. So let me show you how you do that. I've got one of the little needles right here. And I've got my bobbin. So you can see with this bobbin that there's a hole, several holes, but I need to actually take my thread and go through one of these holes and out the other side before I can put on my machine to wind that bobbin. And as I said, with my vision, I just can't do that. I have problems with depth perception and it's really tricky for me to get that thread in there. But using these self-threading needles makes it so quick and easy. So let's say I want to wind my bobbin with this thread. I'm just going to cut off a little piece of thread. Pretend that it's still attached to the comb. And what I want to do is I want to take the needle, and as I said, you don't have to thread it like a regular needle. You just need to pull the thread down into it. Now, I have my glasses here because I thought I'd need that for this, but I don't even need that, so that's great. So now you can see that my needle is threaded. Perfect. Now, all I need to do is to take this needle with the thread attached and pretend it's still in the cone, right? And just put it through from the inside to the outside and pull it along. Okay, so the part that's still inside here would actually be attached to that thread cone. The other part I just pull, the needle comes right off. And now I actually have this thread. Let me just pull this down, it'd be like this. You don't need it this long even, but I've got that in the top. And then I can just put this on my machine, hold onto the top and start that winding process. So that makes it super, super easy. So if you struggle to thread your bobbin, it's not even something we usually say, but if you have a machine where you have to do this type of a technique with your bobbin before you can start winding it, you might want to get some of these self-threading needles because they work really well. I'll put a link in the description below to the ones that I like to use so you can see what I'm talking about. If you like this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up and share it with your quilting friends. And remember to subscribe and hit the bell so you'll be notified the next time I have a new video.